So today we're just going to dive into Opencode plugins, one of the most powerful underutilized features of customizing your own AI coding workflows. So I'm actually going to show you exactly how you can build custom plugins with Opencode, walk you through the architecture, how you should think about it, and some live examples, and also show you how you can do some cool effects like this on screen right now. All right, if that got your attention, this is jump straight into it and starting off with what actually is Opencode plugins. All right, starting off, I just want to state you can actually go find all of this in the Opencode docs. So if you go to Opencode and you just go, you scroll to the bottom here, you can actually see plugins right there. Just click on it and it will take you to the plugin sections right here. All right, what actually are Opencode plugins? Well, the best way to think about plugins is a way that you can extend Opencode. And in essence, it's a way that you can put scripts and connect it to your AI tooling. It's a little bit more sophisticated than that. You can actually build JavaScript and TypeScript modules and connect it to events that happen under the hood in Opencode. So in the past, my video was literally this. You could add your script into your .opencode plugin folder, but you can actually do a lot more than this. You can actually build a package and then share your package with other people across team or, you know, across the globe. And I actually want to talk about how much power is actually in these events that you can hook in to Opencode to really customize it. All right, before I even jump into what events are, how should you think about events here? I think events you should think about as, for example, on screen, like file created. So there's like a little hook that's inserted into Opencode. When a file gets edited, it checks the event first. And if you've got any hooks or plugins tied into this event, it'll execute that first. So think of events as like a middleware between different events that happen under the hood of Opencode. Hopefully that makes a bit of sense for you guys, but that's the best way to think of events. It's just like a way to stop or do a quick check in the processes before it just executes and carries on. And why is this important? Well, for example, file edited, imagine you've got a .env here. You can now make a plugin to double check that Opencode can never look at your environment variables. So you can block that from the get-go. You can also look at your LSP messaging parts, like say if a message is updated, what actually happens to it? You know, how do you want to handle that? But essentially, there's quite a few different ones. Most important ones, I think, are you can use tool execute often before to save like logs. I like the TUI toast show. This is going to be something we'll be talking about in a bit. And the other one is message updated, because we might actually need to see what's happening to the message if we want to do certain events. All right, we're going to just jump into some code so I can show you how this actually works under the hood and how you can use different events for different things. All right, so I'm just going to show you, this is a repo I'm going to post after this. It's just a example plugin structure, but essentially I'm making my own My Little UI plugin here. This is just so I can just show you how you can insert different UI elements and do different hooks and things like that. Also, some of the experimental, you know, a bit of fiddling I was doing just a bit of fun to see if I could customize my own plugin and the limitations of it. Anyway, that going into too much detail, let's just jump into life cycles here. And essentially what I'm going to be talking about in life cycles is I'm going to be doing hooks on when we first start our Opencode and send the first message and try and insert a lot of different events in that that first section, just for testing purposes in this case. All right, so I'm going to go to index here. And on index here, this is essentially where we're trying to get our hooks. So you'll see here, there's this event type equals session created. So every time a new session is created, we're going to call this handle session created function. And in here, we've got different events that we're hooking into events that we're trying to show, toasts and messages and things like that. But we also have this message updated when it's not been updated yet. We probably want a toast to go for the first time. I could do that also in the session updated. I just wanted it to be a bit different here for the first message to see if I can just update a toast on the first message. So this was just some trial thing for me. And we can also change if there's a session error, how do we want things to happen? I'm doing a toast again here, and I'm actually also doing a console.log. All right, I don't want to overburden you with all of this, but let's just jump into the session created section. So in here, we've got when a session is created, we're going to do a few things. We're going to do an open agent banner. So essentially, what does an open agent banner look like? This is the open agent banner here. So it will show in our code. And you'll see I'm using a kind of interesting one here. I'm actually doing await client session prompt, and then I'm telling it where the session is, and then I'm giving it an update to the part of that session. So I'm, you know, essentially setting a part, and I'm saying you don't need to reply to this. So in a way, I'm hijacking the current session. This is kind of where plugins get kind of interesting. You can start changing different events or attributes that are available to you. So for example, here, we're going to also add a prompt at the end, open agents UI plugin is active, how can I help you? So essentially, you can think of this as when you state your first message, you can put an additional prompt underneath that to maybe affect the behavior or how things work. Why would you want to do this? Maybe if you're building your own custom tools for a plugin, you can then add context to that and say, hey, by the way, these are the tools available and you should use it in this order, etc. All right. So, and lastly, the last thing I didn't touch on is when we start a new session, I'm actually getting some logs. And this is just a way I can capture different ones. So I'll capture on tool calls and things like that. All right, and just to show you where those logs are, if we look at the temple here, we can see different logs. And you can see here, I've got all these different logs that are happening. So I can capture all these details. Quite handy if you are trying to code and develop your own plugin, you can keep your logs and see what's going on under the hood. You don't have to jump other places. So quite neat. All right, so let's just run something here. Again, I just want to state what we're looking for. There's going to be a lot that's going to pop on screen. Maybe I should disable it, but for now, what's going to happen is when we send our first message, we're going to expect a go pop-up to happen. We're also going to expect a message of open agents to happen. And if there is an error will pop up, but we'll get to that now. So I'm just going to say hi. By the way, this plugin can work with any agent because we haven't specified which agent it shouldn't work with. It's, you know, it's changing the way our open code is working. So here we go. We've got the go pop-up working and we've got the message. Quite a lot of stuff happening. So that's the message part that we talked about and the go toast that popped up. So quite neat. And we can see open agent plugin is now active. How can I help? And that's literally that sign here. We appended this prompt from the get-go. So now I could change this to say, maybe based on your findings, carry on. So we can really start customizing behavior according to the plugin. But I haven't shown you the error yet, so I just want to show you that quick. So I'm just going to run this, how I can help. And I'm going to press escape, which will make it break in terms of the error. All right. So the toast popped up here. I just want to state that there. The session error. Check the logs for details. And then we've got this error here, which looks kind of imposing. I do want to state this is a console.log. So the console.logs don't work the way you would like them. It doesn't like go into a different log file or anything. It pops in like this. And this is quite important because if you put a console.log on an event that happens all the time, it just takes over your whole window here. And you can't actually see, you know, the text over here. So use console logs very sparingly. I'm just doing it here because it kind of looked cool. But essentially, console.logs fill this up. All right, so one thing you can note, so we've made a plugin here, and we can see we've got an index file and things like that. We've got a button block and a package. So I just want to talk a bit about this if you do want to make your own package. So make sure you've got the name of your package there. You can even set it up with npm install. And what's nice is in Opencode, you can actually link to this. So you can talk what your plugin is, what the name is, and you can also go to the package and link to where the packages come from so it can install. And then this way, you can actually use your Opencode plugin across different repos, and you don't need that .opencode plugin with the script format, you can actually build it in one repo and share it across. Kind of like this, it just makes things a little bit easier. Anyway, I don't want to make this too much of a long video. There's just a lot to go into plugins. I just wanted to give a quick update on how to think about plugins, all the different events that happen under the hood. Just, you know, just getting all these events that you can update and change how things work is super great. And you can really customize your own plugins with different behaviors. I'm actually using this myself to build an extended version of my open agents, so I can force different context files and different workflows. I think this is quite interesting. I'm probably over engineering it, I'll be honest with you, but I'm having a lot of fun testing different scenarios and just seeing if I can get incremental results, then plug that into some evals and see if my behaviors are giving me better results. I just really like this way of slowly getting into the context and understanding what's happening under the hood of my AI tooling so I can customize it for my use case. This was just a quick video talking about OpenCode plugins. I just wanted to give you guys an updated version of how plugins are working and how you can what you can actually do with it in terms of changing the appearance, some of the behaviors, and just giving you a little bit of a peek under the hood on, you know, how events happen. I don't want to make this too overwhelming. And lastly, this is a new video with a new mic. I would really appreciate it if the sound sounds a lot better. And yeah, again, thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.